Okay, once again, good evening, everyone. Let's start the class. As we know that the topic for today's discussion is value putting. Basically, this is a technique which we can use to solve some of the questions in quantitative aptitude. Now, actually, this tech using this particular technique, we can solve a particular question in a very fast manner. And eventually, we will be ending up saving lots of time, right? So we'll be using this particular method in some of the questions, and we'll see that okay, how we are going to use that to solve questions as fast as possible. Let's start with question number one. Question number one, I'll be taking as a demonstration question. I'll try to demonstrate using that particular question, and after that, we'll be solving some questions to understand this particular method in a better way. Now, whiteboard is visible to everyone, right? Okay. Let's start with question number one, which says there is a condition given, right? Okay, if P upon Q plus R plus S is equal to Q upon P plus R plus S is equal to, now there is an equation being given. Now, what could be the possible value of log 30k? We need to find this, right? Now, if I'll be trying to solve this particular question using a trivial method or actual method, I could be able to solve this question after investing my 1 to 2 minutes of time. But this question could be solved within fraction of second. Now, let's see what we need to do to solve this particular types of questions. Now, what we are going to do, okay, we will assume some values for the here. Let's see, given that okay, there is an equation being given that P upon Q plus R plus S is equal to Q upon P plus R plus S. I need to put some values for P, Q, R, S, keeping in mind that that should satisfy the condition given. Now, condition over here is like, I need to take the values in such a way that the ratio of the expression given has to be equal. And now that is being given that that is equal to k, I need to evaluate and find the value of log 30k, right? Now, let's see. What I can do in this particular question, I can easily take the value of p as 1, the value of q as 1, the value of R again as 1, and the value of S as again 1. Now, when I take the value of P, Q, R, S as 1, I just need to find that key whether I'm satisfying the condition given or not. So, if I'm looking for the first condition, that is which is like the expression is P upon Q plus R plus S. So, what will the value of P upon Q plus R plus S? So, that will be equal to 1 upon 3, right? And what about the value of Q upon P plus R plus S? Again, we know that each one is equal to 1, then this expression again results in 1 upon 3. In the same way, we can find that okay, all the expressions are equal when we take the value of P, Q, R, S as 1. So each one is equal to 1 upon 3. In that case, I can say that the value of K is 1 upon 3. So if I need to evaluate the value of log 30 into K, 30K, I know that the value of K is 1 upon 3. I can directly put the value of k as 1 upon 3. So it's like k, what I got? Log 10, right? And we know that the value of log 10 is 1. So basically, what we have learned from this particular question is if we can safely assume the value, but we need to keep one thing in our mind that the value which we are taking that should satisfy the condition given. Here, the condition is that the value of the expression given that has to be equal, which is the value of P upon Q plus R plus S, that has to be equal to the value of Q plus P, Q upon P plus R plus S. So that's my condition. Now, based on that condition, I can assume any value. Okay, I just need to satisfy the condition. I can assume any value and we can evaluate further to find the possible values of the given expression. Getting a point, guys? So, two things you just need to keep in mind. Now, for each and every question, this will be common. The first thing is that we can take any random value, but whatever value I am going to take, that must satisfy the condition given. Let's take another example to understand this, what I mean to say. If in an expression, suppose that if in a question has been given that ki if A, B, C is equal to 1, then A, B, C means A into B into C. If in a question it has been given that if the A into B into C is equal to 1 and no condition is being imposed on A, B, C, I can safely take the value of A, B and C all as 1. If I take the value of A as 1, B again as 1, C again as 1, I can say that the value of A, B, C will be equal to 1. The product of A, B, C will be equal to 1. Now, there could be a condition given that if A, B, C is equal to 1 and A is not equal to B, is not C. So in that case, I can't take the value as random as 1 for each and every one. So in that case, I will be violating the condition given, right? So think of a number. Think of three numbers in terms of A, B, C, whose product will be equal to 1, but the value of A is not equal to value of B is not equal to value of C. So I can safely assume that A is 1. B can like 1 upon 2 and C can be 2. Now in this way, I'll be ending up that A, getting that A is not equal to B is not equal to C, but the product is equal to 1. Now again, there could be a condition like A, B, C are integers. So we need to think like that. Okay, we need to satisfy the value. We need to take the random value so that it should not violate the conditions given. Getting a point, guys? Ye samajh mein aa raha hai sir kisi ko ki main kya bolna cha raha hu? What I'm trying to say? Is this clear? Shall I proceed further? Okay. So let's take another example, question number 2. What's been given? It's been given that if the sum of the roots of the quadratic equation is equal to the sum of the square of their reciprocal, then which of the following options is correct? Now in that case, if I'll be solving this question using a trivial method, that's a basic method, I could be ending up investing lots of my time, right? So how can I approach this particular question using value putting? Just try to solve. Just think for the next 30 seconds that what I can do in this particular question. Think of the condition given and try to assume values. What is the condition given? The condition is that the sum of the roots. Now if someone assumes that the roots are A and B, the condition is that the sum of the roots, that is A plus B, is equal to the sum of the square of their reciprocal. Like, yeah, great Mayank, this is the thing I am going to do. Now this says that this is equal to sum of the square of the reciprocal. So this is the condition given that A plus B is equal to, if A and B are considered as the roots of the equation. So think of a number which I can as a roots A and B. We can safely assume the roots as 1 and 1, right? Both roots are equal, that is 1 and 1. In that case, what I will be now this thing you can think very fast when you are in habit of assuming values, right? So we can say that in that case, if the roots are 1 and 1, the equation will be x minus 1 ka whole square, x minus 1 into x minus 1, right? So we can say that k the equation is x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, if I have satisfied the condition that the sum of the root is equal to the sum of the square of the reciprocal, that has to be true for any equation, right? So, we can say that that this is the equation I can consider. Now, what I need to do, I can just compare the equation given with this equation to obtain the value of P, Q and R. Now, this thing I can do within seconds, right? If I simply assume the value of 1 and 1, the root, the equation will become x square minus 2x plus 1. In that case, come with px square plus qx plus r. Right? And get the value of pqr. What will be the value of pqr? The p will be equal to 1. Q will be equal to minus 2 and R will be equal to 1. Now, third step, what I'm going to check, I'm going to check through the options given that in that case, if I take the values of P is equal to 1, R is equal to 2, Q is equal to minus 2 and R is equal to 1, in which of the following options the conditions are satisfied. So what you'll see, if you put the values of P, Q, R in the options given, what we'll see, this satisfies for both option A and C. Get the value of P, Q, R, put it over there, and you'll see that this satisfies for both A and C. So basically, this particular method serves as a boon for those students who think that their math is somewhat weak, on a weaker section, right? So this serves as one of the alternative to solve a question as fast as possible. Getting a point, guys? Okay, so these first two questions I've shown you as an example that how we're going to take the values and how we're going to satisfy the condition to arrive at the right answer. Now, let's see how we're going to apply that in the next question. Question number 3, I'll be providing you with 1 minute of time, 1 to 2 minutes of time. Try to solve this question. Question number 3. Anyone with the answers or any clue that how they're going to proceed in terms of value putting? Now, let's look into the conditions given, guys. The condition is, for this particular equation, if the root of the equation and the ratio of 2 is to 3, the condition is like, I need to consider roots in the ratio 2 is to 3. In that case, which of the following options are true, right? This is being asked. Now, what I'm going to do, what I'm going to take, it's like, we can take the roots in the ratio 2 is to 3, this has been given. So, we can directly take the roots as 2 and 3 now. Now, what is the first thing which comes into your mind when I say that the roots of the ratio 2 is to 3? I can safely take the root as 2 and 3. First step. The second. Yeah, and you correct. Option D is the right answer. Now, first step is I can safely take the value of the roots, but try to solve this question using the value putting method, which I'm discussing. Now, when you get a habit to solve the question using this, most of the questions of algebra you can quickly solve by just putting some random values, satisfying the condition given. Now, I can safely take the value as 2 and 3 roots as 2 and 3. Now, with the roots and 2 and 3, I can write the equation as x minus 2 into x minus 3. As we know that if you get the root as 2 and the root as alpha and beta, I can write the equation in the form of x minus alpha into x minus beta, right? Ninth class maths, right? So just multiply it, we obtain the equation as x square minus 5x plus 6. Now, the third step is more similar, which we have done in question number 2. I can directly compare this particular equation with the equation 3x squared plus 2bx plus c is equal to 0. Right? I can compare this equation x squared minus 5x plus 6 directly with the equation given. And in this way, I can get the value of a, b, and c. Like a will be equal to 1 upon 3, b will be equal to minus 5 upon 2, and c will be equal to 6, right? Now, what I need to do, go through the options and put the value of a, b, and c and just check that which of the options satisfy the condition. Option D is the answer. When you put the value of B and A and C in option D, you will see that LHS will be equal to RHS. And that's the answer. Now, perhaps after solving these three questions, you must have got the gist that what we are going to do is we are taking some random values based on the condition given. The value should not be like that, that it violates the condition. So we need to take the value like that. And then we need to proceed to solve the question. So let's proceed, guys. Just wait, I'm sharing the sheet 2. The seat is visible, right? Now, let's try to apply this in this particular question, question number 4 and 5. Let's solve question number 4 first. I'll wait for the next 1 minute. Try to answer this. Okay, let's see what's given in this particular question, question number 4. It says that after receiving 2 successes, her salary become on 8 times the initial salary. By how much percent was the salary raised the first time if the second raised was twice as high in percent as the first? Now the options are also given in the terms of percentage. You need to find out about how much percent was the salary raised. Now let's try to understand that what's been given in this particular question. If there are 2 raised, now suppose that if I'm saying that the salary increased by 50%. So in that case, suppose that if I considered 1 as 100%, the fraction part with which the salary is increased can be 1 upon 2, right? So we can say that the increased salary is, which is 50% more than the initial one, right? So we can write it in terms of anything, we can write it in terms of a percentage increase, we can write in terms of 1 plus f, right? I repeat it, suppose that if I'm saying that the salary increased by 20%, so what I can do for that, in that case, f will be 1 upon 5. So 20% of 1 is 1, so 20% of 1 is 1 upon 5, okay? So in that case, small f will be 1 upon 5, right? Okay. Now using this, what I can do, now this is the method to represent the increased in terms of percentage, right? Now let's try to understand this particular question. What's been given? It says that after receiving 2 successive raises, her salary become equal to 50. Now let's 8 times the initial salary. Let's assume that the initial salary is X. Now there are 2 increased in the salary, and finally the salary becomes 15 upon 8 times the initial one. Now is the condition given on the raised? It's been given that, but how much percent was the salary raised the first time if the second raise was twice as high as the first one? So I can say that if the first raise is of F, the second raise is of 2F. Now compare this, we need to put the value of F. In this particular equation, we need to take the value of that, which value of F satisfy this particular equation. So compare the LHS with RHS. Now what I can do, 15 upon 8x can be written as 5 upon 4 into 3 upon 2. Now why I have done this, let's try to find it out. 5 upon 4 is what? 1 upon 1 plus 4, and 3 upon 2 is what? 1 upon 1 by 2. Now this breakage of 15 upon 8 into 2 factors, 5 upon 4 into 3 by 2x, is satisfy my condition that is if the increase is twice as high as the first one. So if the first increase is 1 upon 4, that is 25%. The second increase is 1 upon 2, that is 50%. This satisfies the condition, right? So I can easily, safely take the value of F as 1 upon 4 for the first part and 1 upon 2 for the second part. Now what I did, I just wrote a simple equation in terms of F. Now breaking 15 upon 8 in 2 part, I was just trying to assume the value of F which satisfy the condition. The condition, what is the condition given? Like the previous question here, the condition is like the second rise is twice the first rise. So we can see that the value of H, F which satisfies is 1 upon 4. 1 upon 4 is how much? That is 25%. So we can easily get the answer for this particular question. Getting a point, guys? Let's move to the next question. The next question says, find the number of real roots of the equation. The equation is being given and we need to find the number of real roots. Now let's try to understand that k of the equation is off. Is Mayank, you got the right answer? Good. What is the root of the equation? The root of the equation is that value that satisfies that particular equation. In the other word, in layman language, we can say the zeros of the equation, right? So in this particular equation given, let's see the power of x. We can see that the power of x are even, right? All power of x. Sorry, there is some values missing. This has to be 2x squared plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, this is the question being given. Now, let's try to assume values of x which can satisfy this particular equation. Now, we can see that any values of x, real values of x, the left hand side expression can't be equal to 0. Then if we take the negative value, in that case the power of x is positive for even for the power of x is even for every expression. So in that case, for even negative value, it won't be satisfying the condition that left hand side cannot be equal to the RHS, right hand side, right? So any value of x is not possible. If we start the value putting, we'll see that no value of x is possible, right? So in that case, what would be the number of real roots of the equation? That will be equal to 0. Right? Okay. You got it, everyone? So we move to the next question, guys. Number 6. Now here the function which is being given is a modulus function, right? Now if we will try to solve this particular question using a method of graph or any trivial method, you will be ending up losing 3 to 4 minutes time. But we can directly substitute the value. Now this is a perfect example of putting up the values from the options given, right? That here the expression is mod x minus 2 plus 2 mod 2.5 minus x plus mod 3.6 minus x, where x is a real number, attains a minimum at. So what I can do, I can directly substitute, I can directly put the values of x from the options given. Like if I put option A, so this would be like if x is equal to 2.3, so each and every place of x, you can put the value 2.3. Okay. And you can obtain the value of this expression. Now, keep in my mind, I need to check that the value of this expression needs minimum. Now, just four values substitution, and you will get to find that when we put the value of x as 2.5, we'll get the expression value as minimum possible, which is not possible for A, C and D. So B will be the answer. Now this is a question, which is an example that we can take the values directly from the options, we can put in the expression and can get the answer of the question, right? So let's proceed, guys. Let's move to the next set of questions. Just wait for a minute. Now let's see how many have learned the art of value putting. Tell me the answer for question number 7. For a minute, guys. Let's see that how many of you are able to solve this particular question in a minute. Good man. Okay, I have got two answers. Yogesh, good. Now, let's see what the condition been given. Right. It says that ki A, B, C are positive integer which is a multiple of 3, 4 and 5. Theek hai? Okay, just wait. I am switching into the whiteboard. Yes. Let's see the question given. It says that ki A, B, C are positive integers which are the multiple of 3, 4 and 5. This has been given that ki A, B, C are the multiple of 3, 4 and 5 respectively, right? Okay. There's again some conditions given. Now what are the condition? It is known that A is equal to B upon 2. The first condition is ki A has to be equal to B upon 2. Now I need values keeping in mind that the value of A needs to be equal to B upon 2, and we know that ki A, B are the multiple of 3 and 5 respectively, right? And the there is one more condition given, that the product of A and B has to be greater than 4C. 4 into C. And what about C? We know that ki C is a multiple of 5, right? Now, what I need to obtain is given the least possible values of A plus B plus C. I need to minimize the value of A plus C, right? Now, let's try to assume values. We know that ki A, B and C are the multiple of 3, 4 and 5 respectively, and they are positive integers. So the first multiple of 4, now it's like I can take the value of b as 4, but in that case the value of a will be 2, which is not a multiple of 3, right? The next multiple of 4, if I take 8, I can't find the value of a as it's not, it won't be an integer. Sorry, it will be not a multiple of 3, right? Now the next value I can safely take is 12, which is multiple of 4. In that case, a will be equal to 6. Now just check that whether it's a multiple, so the condition, yes, a is a multiple of 3 and b is a multiple of 4 and a is equal to b upon 2. Possible? Now a into b will be equal to, so the minimum value which satisfy the positive integer which satisfy this particular conditions given is a is equal to 6 and b equal to 2. In that case, the product of a and b is equal to 72. Now, what can we say about the value of c? The first value which satisfy this particular condition is the value of c. I can take 5. In that case, 5 into 4, 20. And we know 72 is greater than 20. So in that case, we can safely take the value of c as 5, right? Now, this is the minimum values of a, b, and c which we have obtained. So in this case, we can say that the value of least possible value of a plus b plus c will be 6 plus 12 plus 5. That is 23. Did you learn the technique, guys? That what is given in the question and just trying to satisfy the condition by taking the random values, keeping in my mind that I just need to satisfy the conditions which is being given in the question, right? Okay. Now, in this way, if we'll solve this particular question number 8, I'm talking about, this can be solved within 2 to 3 seconds. How? Let's see. That the condition given is if A upon, that might not be visible in the sheet. The condition is ki if A upon B plus C is equal to B upon C plus A is equal to C upon A plus B. This has been given. Okay? Where A, B, C are positive real numbers, then find the value of each of these ratios. Now, let's take that if this is equal to K, we need to find the value of K. Now, what is the condition given? The A, B, C are positive real numbers, right? So, what is the value of A, B, and C which we can safely take in this particular conditions? We can take the value of A, B, C as 1, right? As we have seen in the previous question also, that there is no condition imposed on that whether A, B, C are equal or not. So we can easily take, safely take the value of A, B, C as equal. In that case, what will be the value of expression? The value of expression is 1 upon 2. Getting a point, guys? So, if you try to solve this question using traditional method, you will be ending up investing most of your time, right? Now, let's move into the last question of this particular session. Let's look in the condition given and listen the expression. AB plus BC plus that has to be equal to 0. Then we give the expression 1 upon a square minus bc plus 1 upon b square minus ac plus 1 upon c square minus ab. Now, can anyone tell me that any value of abc which we can safely take which can satisfy this particular condition? Now, 0, 0, 0, if you take the value of each value as 0, now let's look at the expression that is 1 upon a square minus bc. That will result in 1 upon 0. That is not defined, right? So I can't take the value of abc or 0. Yes, definitely. We can take the value. We can take the value as a equal to 2, b equal to to c equal to minus 1. Yeah, definitely, we can take any value. We just need to make sure that this should satisfy the condition given, which is ab plus bc plus ca, that has to be equal to 1. Okay? Now, the moment I get the condition, put those values in the expression given and get the answer. Getting a point, guys? So, the gist of this particular session, the value putting, is like, this can be taken as an alternative method to solve some of the question based on algebra, where we can directly put some random values to solve the question. But we need to make sure one thing, that whatever random values which we are taking to put in the equation, that should satisfy the condition given and that shouldn't violate the conditions given the question. Like, we have seen that in each and every question, there are some conditions given, and based on that, we need to find the value of the expression, we need to find the minimum or the maximum values. But there will be some condition given. So we need to take values like that should satisfy the condition, and based on that, we can put that particular values in the expression to arrive at the solution. Getting a point? So I hope this particular technique of solving question using value putting is clear. That's all for today, guys. Thanks a lot. Thank you everyone for attending the class.